here, okay? I'm not giving this away here, but I don't want him to pull this arm out. So as he begins to, here and here, as I'm just pulling this down and lifting my hip and pulling it into my chest, I need to keep moving his weight left and right, just so I can pop my head out of here, okay? And now from here, I lock it. I still need to put him in that sweet spot right here, because if his shoulder is too much on my kind of chest right here, it's not in that sweet spot. The sweet spot is right about there. So then my right hand can go up his lat. And from here, I'm just gonna squeeze and walk my hips in. Then if he keeps walking his feet the other way, I'm gonna keep twisting him to be able to get him on his side and lock in the toes. All right, so for those of you who were here last week, Dars, let's say we're gonna go the other way. So we're gonna do it with the left hand. Where'd you head, that way? So we did it with the right hand. Here. Here. Hold. We just did the Dars last week with the right hand, shooting through, so that we have this on. Okay. That's why I did it on the same side. That's sometimes get in your this side. That's your left side. I like to shoot the Dars on my right. Some like to do the Dars like this. They go like this, and then they shoot it in this way. I don't really care for doing the Dars like this, but you also can, because it puts us in the same position as we were in. So if you go down his side, it's all backwards, reverse. So here, shot this in here. You can do the Dars like this. Stretch it and reach here and lock it through here.
So you can catch it from the turtle too, right?
Yeah, from the from the turtle you could, but from the turtle you, I'd prefer to do a Japanese neck wrap and dump on the side. So here, we see how he goes to the knees and then keep walking. Hook a leg, I don't care which leg, because here it's a done deal. Does that kind of make sense? So for those of you who are just starting, I'll give you two options. Push it here on your left, this is how we did it the other day. This is why I always do the Dars, because everybody's passing to the left. So your right hand will be the Dars. That would be the Dars on the other side. So in here, pull my ear down. Pushed his head towards his navel, reached through here, clamped, did the violin as my left forearm, and formed inner elbow, I'm pushing down, and I'm bringing my left tricep. And here you can just square up, squeeze, lifting the left elbow up off the mat, driving your shoulder, squeeze it. You can finish like this. So for you, this will be the Dars, okay? For those of you who are a little bit more advanced, you can go from the bottom, all right? The key to any Dars is to walk the free hand up the back, because Because the whole objective is to move the bottom arm up into the neck. If this arm is not high enough, the bottom arm will not create the pressure that's needed to create the choke. Does that make sense? So, look here, I want to pull his head down. I'm going to stretch my arm out and see how I dip my head. My arm's only so long. The more my arm head is here, that's about as far as it can go. If I bring my head back here, I can stretch it out. And then I'm pushing that way towards his belly button. As my, so when I start the violin, this is just to hold his head in place so it doesn't open. Okay, I'm not really trying to push it down, I'm just trying to prevent it from opening up because his defense really is to move his head back. Does that make sense? So I have to grab the Yamakizil, lock it, get some action sounds here, tricep, and then this hand, see how high it goes? If I'm here, Christian, is it tight?
No.
Is it tight?
No.
How about now?
Tighter.
Tighter now?
Mm-hmm.
How about now? Yeah? Okay. So you see the significance of this hand, right?
Are you just moving that up like that?
Off your back? Yes. That wasn't my hand, Christian. No, just kidding. So, we're here. He wants the pass. I shot my hand through here. The second I anticipate, and I'm here, he's not gonna bring it over. Right here. And then I wanna roll him up here as I walk it out this way and pop my head out from here, keeping this flat. And now I wanna drop into the sweet spot. And from here, I can begin to twist and dump him on his side here. I can finish him here too. And then walk my feet down. Trying to hook. And you can finish it as he's trying to see. Because he just stuck. And they don't really, unless you really know specifically the physical flat, you're going to get caught. Okay? So, we got beginner, intermediate, advanced. Let's do it. One, two, three. So, if you want to, I need somebody to go with Jonathan.